Hi, I'm Tom Peters. For the past couple of years, I've been telling managers that competition is making it increasingly hard to stand out from the crowd. I've said it's not good enough to be just like everybody else. You need to reimagine everything. To do this, I've especially spoken long and loud about the importance of design. I've emphasized the need to be agile, innovative, and responsive to competition. I've said that you need to realize that customers come in all ages, all shapes, and all sizes. In this program, you will see how one company has been able to use these ideas extremely successfully, and in the process, literally revolutionize an industry that had remained unchanged for decades. Their new idea started in the kitchen. With the help of smart design, Sam Farber started a new company, OXO Good Grips. Their first test for the new company was at the Gourmet Trade Show in 1990.
It was a miracle that the product actually arrived at the Gourmet Show 2 days before the show opened. We'd built a booth to display it that looked like we'd been in business for 10 years, and we just stood back and watched.
There were people who said, it's a big fat handle peeler. I mean, why should I buy that, you know? But within I'd say a year to 18 months, it started to get across that this was something different from all the rest of the products on the market.
The peeler became OXO's signature product, but it also represented the foundation of a new design philosophy.
We were one of the early proponents, I don't even think we knew that we were at the time, of what's called universal design, which is to make easy-to-use products for as wide a spectrum of the populace as possible.
OXO Good Grips is not your typical company. They think differently about their customers, their products, and their entire corporate structure. They have, yes, revolutionized the kitchen houseware industry. Here's what you can do to put these ideas to work in your organization. First, think differently and trust your gut. Sam Farber didn't use marketing experts and focus groups to come up with a product that would appeal to an 18 to 35-year-old. He thought of something that would appeal to all ages, be they young or be they old. He used his absolute love of great design to turn that idea into something truly exciting and truly different. To succeed, you need to think differently about your customers and your products. Second, design matters.